Deputy Prime Minister, Minister of Energy and Public Utilities, Honorable Hon’ble COLLENDAVELLOO, Minister of Art and Culture, Honorable Pradip Rupan, Minister of Business, Enterprises and Cooperative, Honorable Sumiljat Gola, the President and Managing Committee of the Gahlot Rajput Maha Sabha, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, all protocol observed, Kamagami Namaskar Sabhiku or Swagat. Welcome to the 477th birth anniversary of the Maharana of the Rajput Shiromani Maharana Pratap Singh Sisodia. Every nation feels proud of Maharana Pratap Singh and would wish to produce one alike. He is cherished as one of the greatest sons of India. He will always be remembered as a national hero. Rana was a great warrior, brave Rajput, and a true patriot. I have no doubt that all parents would wish that their children shall follow the path of traced by him. My responsibility this afternoon is to introduce the keynote speaker of this year's celebration, who came all along from India. Please permit me to do more than cite the qualification of our keynote speaker. There are many young peoples in this gathering who will benefit from an outline of what constitutes a good Rajput man and a good Rajput leader. My introduction of Commander Pratap Singh Mehta includes these definitions, hence its length. We have invited him to be our special guest and a keynote speaker because he shares abundantly these virtues. First, a good Rajput man is one who has high regard of his nation, family, and children. Caring for the welfare and future of the nations, family and one's own children is a premium virtue of Rajput men and women. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to know a bit about today's keynote speaker, Commander Pratap Singh Mehta ji. Commander Pratap Singh Mehta ji, Bharatiya Nav Sena ke varishth adhikari rahe hain, jinhone 1971 ke Bharat Pak Yudh mein सक्रिय योगदान दिया. समृद्ध विज्ञान से स्नातक की डिग्री लेने वाले प्रताप सिंह मेहता की रुचि हमेशा से ही राजपूताना की इतिहास और उनके परंपराओं में रुचि है. और वो भी क्यों ना, आखिरकार वे मेवाड़ के प्रभावशाली प्रधानमंत्री श्री पन्नालाल जी के अनुज, सैन्य कमांडर लक्ष्मीलाल जी मेहता के प्रपोत्र जो है. He is a graduate of Indian Naval Academy and Defence Services Staff College and a postgraduate in Management Studies. Commander Mehta was both a mariner and an aviator in the Indian Navy. Bharatiya Nav Sena se commander ke roop mein retire hone se pehle vibhin mahatvapurna paddon par karya karne ke unhein avsar prapt hua. As a sea-going captain, he commanded a squadron of missile boat, and as a naval aviator, he commanded an air squadron. Ve purva Soviet Union mein 1979-80 ke dauran INS Rajput ke commissioning crew bhi the. Born and bred in Udaipur, Commander Mehta has spent his formative years in Rajasthan and now lives in Mumbai with his family after retirement from the Indian Navy in 1994. He is married to Mrs. Shail G. Mehta, who is present today with us. They have a daughter and a son, both married and live in Mumbai. His son, Nakul Mehta, is a leading television star who features a daily show, Ishq Baaz, on Star Plus. Commander Mehta is an author of recently published Coffee Table, Rajputana Chronicles, Gun and Glories, the thousand-year story of the Bachawat clan. His childhood fascination with the story of his ancestors is what eventually led him to do a very extensive research that resulted in his book. It's not only his labor of love, but a token of gratitude towards all those who came before and laid the foundation of the great Bachawat clan. In the word of Commander Mehta, what will be all if not for our ancestors? I shall quote Michael Crichton, if you didn't know history, you didn't know anything. You were a leaf that did not know it was part of a tree. I also take this opportunity to invite the president of Gahlot Rajput Maha Sabha, Mr. Roshun to receive a copy of the Rajputana Chronicles, Guns and Glories from the author, our very special guest, Commander Pratap Singh Ji Mehta himself.
Bonzur Mauris. Honorable Deputy Prime Minister, sir, honorable ministers and members of Parliament. Gahlot Rajput Maha Sabha President, Mr. Roshun SEEBUN, Secretary General, Mr. Pravesh SAWON, members of the Managing Committee, the distinguished guests and friends. The first thing I would like to say is, thank you, Pravesh Ji, for this generous introduction. Not only that, Gahlot Rajput Maha Sabha of Mauritius has given me this extraordinary honor, but also the weeks of nausea and fear that have endured at thought of giving this keynote address has made me look a little older and lose some weight as well. Friends, it's a win-win situation. Now all I have to do is take deep breaths and relax and look at some of the banners which have been put around outside and convince myself that I am at the world's best Maharana Pratap Diwas celebration. Thank you. Friends, I am pleased by the strong attendance. I am particularly delighted to see many young people in the gathering. Very happy to see quite a few young people. Delivering a keynote address is a great responsibility. It's an absolute honor for us to be taking part in the pageant for the celebration of 477th anniversary of legendary warrior and son of the soil, Maharana Pratap Singh Ji. Today, it is Pratap on Pratap. It will always be remembered by me and my wife, Shail Mehta, who is present here today. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Rajputana, Jan Bhumi Sheron Ki, Karm Bhumi रण भूमि, वो माटी जिसके एक एक जर्रे में, रेत के हर एक कण में सदियों सदियों का इतिहास छुपा है, इतिहास जो भरा है कहानियों से, किंवदंतियों से, द बार्ड्स द स्टोरीज, जैसा कि अंग्रेजी में कहा जाता है, हिस्ट्री दैट बिकेम लेजेंड, लेजेंड दैट बिकेम मिथ. एंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू राजपुताना, नो लेजेंड नो माइथोलॉजी इज बिगर देन दैट ऑफ द ग्रेट महाराणा, द महाराणा प्रताप. महाराणा प्रताप की कहानी शौर्य पराक्रम और बलिदान का अद्भुत मिश्रण है. सच कहें तो उनकी कहानी कभी किसी कलम या किसी भाषा की मोहताज नहीं रही है. इसके लेखक तो वे खुद महान योद्धा थे जिन्होंने गुलामी से जकड़े हुए हिंदुस्तान में मरते दम तक वीरता और स्वाभिमान का परचम लहराया. दोस्तों, स्याही से लिखी हुई कहानियां मिट सकती हैं, खून से नहीं. स्टोरीज रिटन इन इंक मे फेड अवे बट नॉट द वंस रिटन इन ब्लड. आज से कई पीढ़ियों पहले कुछ लोग भारत से कुछ लोग एक नए जीवन, एक नई राह, एक नए बसेरे की तलाश में मॉरिशस आए थे. उन सभी के लिए हम भारत से ढेर सारा प्यार सद्भावना लेकर आए हैं. आज के समारोह में मेवाड़, जो महाराणा प्रताप की जन्मस्थली है, मेवाड़ और मॉरिशस के इस अद्भुत संगम को देखकर बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है. दोस्तों, मेवाड़ के आकाश में यूं तो कई महान योद्धा पैदा हुए जो सितारों की तरह चमके, लेकिन सूरज तो सिर्फ एक था, एक है, महाराणा प्रताप. Maharana Pratap, a Hindu Rajput king from the Sisodia clan, ruled Mewar from the year 1572 to 1597 AD. He is revered and worshipped by many in India and overseas for his bravery and courage, for leadership and management. People even take today the management lessons. The management institutes talk about his case studies, about his war strategies, about how he looked after his people. A true patriot who initiated the first war of independence from the Islamic invaders in India. He is the true patriot. Someone who ruled Mewar for only 25 years, but within that comparatively short period earned so much glory and fame that it crossed boundaries of country and he became immortal. He and his kingdom have become synonymous with bravery, sacrifice and pride in one's own country. Perish, but do not surrender. Nasht ho jao, lekin samarpan na karo. Yeh Rajputana ki sadiyon se chali aa rahi parampara thi. Pran jaye par vachan na jaye. Lekin is parampara ko Maharana Pratap ke pita Maharana Uday Singh ji ne तोड़ा था. उन्होंने भगवान श्री कृष्ण की नीति अपनाई. शायद आप लोगों को मालूम होगा वो क्या नीति है. न नष्ट होना न समर्पण करना, neither perish nor surrender. That if you must leave the battle to win the war, then do it. You can only win a war if you live to see another day. That's very important for all of us to learn today from this strategy. Maharana Pratap was the sharpest, shrewdest exponent of this war strategy. The same strategy that gave Lord Krishna himself the name. Do you remember what Lord Krishna got the name? Ranchor. When Jarasandh attacked Mathura to take revenge from Krishna, Krishna shifted his capital to Dwarka. You cannot win a war unless you capture that land. If the ruler is not there, what will you capture? This is a great strategy. Navy can go and bombard the enemy land. Pakistan can go and destroy the airfield. But it is the army who goes and captures the land, the important strategic positions. Then it is a victory, like what we did in Bangladesh. जब महाराणा प्रताप का जन्म हुआ तब दिल्ली के तख्त पर बादशाह अकबर का शासन था और उनकी रणनीति थी कि सभी राजा महाराजाओं को अपने अधीन कर राजपुताना पर मुगल साम्राज्य का ध्वज फहराना. निश्चित तौर पर मेवाड़ को जीतना उनकी इस योजना का सबसे बड़ा हिस्सा था. अकबर ने महाराणा प्रताप को अपने साथ आने का कई बार न्योता दिया, इनवाइटेड हिम नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स, लेकिन महाराणा प्रताप ने उनकी गुलामी स्वीकार नहीं की. इनफैक्ट अमंग ऑल द राजपूत रूलर्स ऑफ 16th सेंचुरी महाराणा प्रताप वाज द ओनली वन हु डिड नॉट सरेंडर टू एम्परर अकबर. इट वाज द बैटल ऑफ हल्दीघाटी. It was the Battle of Haldighati that made history, and it shall still be remembered by people in generations to come. It's alive in the songs of bards. It's alive in the songs of bards, so much so that not just Maharana Pratap, his horse Chetak also became immortalized. There are poems that are taught to school children in India even to this day. Here are two lines from the poem Chetak Ki Veerta, written by Kavi Shyam Narayan Pandey. Gaur kahiye, Ran beech chaukadi bhar bhar kar Chetak ban gaya nirala tha. Ran beech chaukadi bhar bhar kar Chetak ban gaya nirala tha. Rana Pratap ke ghode se पड़ गया हवा का पाला था. पड़ गया हवा का पाला था. इन द बैटल फील्ड चेतक द हॉर्स ऑफ राणा प्रताप वॉज यूनिक एज ही वॉज स्विफ्टर देन द विंड. हवा जो तनिक हवा से बाघ हिली लेकर सवार उड़ जाता था. जो तनिक हवा से बाघ हिली लेकर सवार उड़ जाता था. राणा की पुतली फिरी नहीं तब तक चेतक मुड़ जाता था. Chetak would take off with the mere thought of its master. He would turn around before Rana would turn his head. He was so swift. He was so intelligent. He would read the mind of Rana. So Chetak was also immortalized along with Rana Pratap in the battle of Haldighati. Of course, you know, he died. Veerra se bhari ye kavita सिर्फ महाराणा प्रताप के घोड़े के बारे में ही लिखी जा सकती है, अन्य घोड़ों के बारे में नहीं. हल्दीघाटी की लड़ाई कई मायनों में अनूठी थी. द स्ट्रेंजेस्ट बैटल इन हिस्ट्री. डू यू नो फ्रेंड्स, दिस लास्टेड ओनली फॉर 4 आवर्स. उन 4 घंटों में भी राणा प्रताप ने अकबर की विशालकाय सेना को नाकों चने चबवा दिया. सोचो, एक तरफ अकबर की 200,000 लोगों की फौज और उसके सामने ओनली 22,000 Rajput Yodha, Magar wo date rahe, defeated the Mughals because of their strategy and chivalry. It was one of the strangest but the greatest war. Ant mein bhale yudh chhod kar jana pada, lekin tab tak arne parakram se Rajputana ke ithihas ka sabse gauravpurn adhyay likh chuke the. Maharana Pratap was not just a brave warrior, caring king and valiant leader, but also a man of principles. Wo siddhantwadi bhi the. He never tried any unjust means to transgress from the rules of warfare to win over his enemies. Wo dhoke se yudh nahi jeet na uske firtak mein nahi tha. Friends, I will tell you a story of Kachhawa Raja, Raja Man Singh of Jaipur, the Mughal army general in Akbar's time. Once Maharana got to know Raja Man Singh's whereabouts in the jungle, he could have easily attacked him when the latter was busy hunting and enjoying. But he did not backstab him. Maharana's distinction of being just was a rare leadership trait. Bahut kam us tarah ke logon mein ye paayi jaati hai. Ek aur kissa hai Rahim Khan Iran ke bare mein, jo Mughal sena mein adhikari tha. Wo lagatar Mewar ke khilaf shadyant rache ja raha tha. Jab Maharana Pratap ke bete Kunwar Amar Singh रहीम के घर की कुछ औरतों को उठा लाया तो महाराणा ने उसे खूब लताड़ा और तुरंत उन महिलाओं को सम्मान के साथ वापस भेजने की हिदायत दी. रहीम उनकी इस दरिया दिली से गदगद हो उठा और उसने तय किया कि मेवाड़ के खिलाफ मुगल साजिश में अब वो हिस्सा नहीं लेगा. बहुत बड़ी बात है. There are thousands of stories like this. Maharana Pratap's life is also a lesson on how to stand ground against all diversities. After the Battle of Haldighati, when he was wandering in forests to keep away from the Mughal army, his family suffered many hardships. His wives and children had to starve and spend sleepless nights under unfavorable circumstances in forests. Such a catastrophe initially forced him to think of surrendering to Akbar and signing a treaty of peace. Kaun nahi karega? But the very next moment, he discarded such thoughts and gathered courage to fight Akbar once again. He didn't give up. With only a small penniless inheritance, Pratap proved himself in face of insurmountable difficulties, a great leader of men, a generous enemy, and above all, a prince among men. His name will ever have a permanent and prominent niche in the halls of valor, patriotism, and heroism. Doston, जब भी वीरता देशभक्ति और अदम्य साहस की बात होगी महाराणा प्रताप का नाम सबसे पहले पूरी शान से लिया जाएगा. महाराणा प्रताप का नाम पूरी शान से लिया जाएगा. इट गिव्स मी अ ग्रेट सेंस ऑफ प्राइड एंड ऑनर दैट मॉरिशस हैज अ मेमोरियल फॉर महाराणा प्रताप एंड दिस नेशन सेलिब्रेट्स हिज बर्थ एनिवर्सरी एवरी ईयर. Before concluding, I would once again like to thank everyone for honoring Rajputana's greatest hero in the greatest fashion. I would also like to implore and encourage all of you to visit historical Mewar cities like Udaipur, which is also a famous international touristic landmark these days. history, culture, beauty, lakes, festivals, mineral wealth, art and craft, what not, heritage, it all represents in the most glorious of Indian cities. There is great Maharana Pratap Memorial built in the city, and it's one of the must visit places for anyone interested in the story of great Maharana. Finally, friends, Maharana Pratap's story is just a single page of the glorious history of Mewar and Rajasthan and that of India. If you book a flight to India and visit Rajasthan, you can turn many such colorful pages of Rajputana history. Brave and majestic, the two adjectives that will forever define both Maharana and the Rajputana. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Maharana Pratap, Jai Mauritius, Jai Hind. Vote a Premidi. Thank you once again.
Singh Mehta, veteran of the Indian Army, sometimes called Captain because he was a captain in the Merchant Navy, but also commander in the Indian Navy and also the helicopter squadrons with good colors to fly, but also a now renowned author, the Rajputana Chronicles. I would invite everyone to check on Twitter. Check him on Twitter, this is what I've done. It's fascinating to read about you. I am honored to be taking the floor in your presence, sir. I have to state my gratitude to the SAWON for that great invitation to address you. This is the commemoration of the birth of that great king of Mewar, Rana Pratap Singh, the hero of Rajasthan. To have been the chief guest of the Sabha today is something which I will remember and cherish all my life. We have heard with attention and devotion the speech of our friend, Captain Commander Pratap Mehta. There is not much that I can add to this masterpiece of history which you have delivered today. Maharana Pratap Singh was born in 1540 and died in 1597, crowned king at the age of 32, prominent warrior against the Mughal of the invasion of India. In his book entitled Medieval India, written in 2000, Satish Chandra, a prominent historian, specialized in medieval history of India, had this to say: Rana Pratap's defiance of the mighty Mughal Empire, almost alone and unaided by other Rajput states, constitute a glorious saga of Rajput valor and spirit of self-sacrifice for cherished principles. Rana Pratap's methods of sporadic warfare was later elaborated further by Malikamba, the Deccani general, and by Shivaji. He resisted all attempts by Mughal Emperor Akbar to surrender. Akbar sent 6 diplomatic missions to seek an arrangement. He was alone, but each of these diplomatic missions were met with defiance. Alone against the mighty army of the Mughals, this Rajput king would never surrender. This is the valor of the Rajputs as transmitted from generation to generation, even today and even across the diaspora. History is the witness of the bravery demonstrated during the different battles, but most particularly the Battle of Haldighati, as well recounted by Commander. An extremely ferocious defense, a retreat, but not a surrender. The Maharana Pratap Singh is also an example of humility and perseverance for the world even today. In a world where everything seems to be materialistic, it is important to recollect that he was a king, a Maharaja. He left the comfort of his palace for the forest because his principles were those which he cherished above most, having to go to war rather than to surrender to leadership.